And the ilang you mentioned 60 schools. This is not only in Tacloban but
and for the whole of the Visayas.
Visayas, yes.
Kwan lang yun. Of course, that's the, as far as the armed forces of the Philippines is concerned, mm-hmm. where CENTCOM is directly involved. But of course, other government agencies are also have their own kwan.
Ito yung direkta kaming ano, participation, mm-hmm. aming engineers, saka yung aming mga tauhan.
What other infrastructures are being prioritized in rehabilitating these areas?
Mayroong palengke, mm-hmm. mayroong House of Justice na ni-repair. Mayroong, yun, sabi nga ni General Bivar na yung veterans. Bahay ng mga veterano. And, yun na nga, yung schools talaga ang napakarami.
So, it's our Army engineers who are at the forefront of the
Army and the Navy and the Air Force.
So, everyone. Yes.
But mostly na Army because Army we have engineer. The 53rd Engineering Brigade. Mm-mm.
And yun na nga, maraming contribution din ng ROKAF, Republic of Korean Armed Forces.
Mm-mm. I think last time I went to Tacloban, it was with Sakan Air Dev. I think that school was built by the Koreans. Yes. Mm-hmm. And I believe that weekend then, a school was turned over by Guam National Guard.
Yes, yes. Mayroon din.
Mayroon din ang Guam. Hawaiian.
Hawaii mayroon din.
So, ang dami nila.
Oo. And I think we're very thankful for our foreign partners for this.
Yeah.
Without them, we could not have achieved what we have achieved.
Yes,
now.
Definitely. I think December 1, we're giving awards to the Koreans. Because I know pretty well that they're leaving soon.
Mm-mm.
Before the end of the year, they're going back to Korea.
Korea.
So, with 1 year that they stay here, ang dami nilang nagawa.
Mm-mm.
And the Secretary of National Defense is scheduled to give them award in recognition to their so many assistance and efforts in helping the
countless.
Yes, countless.
Meron nga rin tayong kasabihan na yung insurgency ends when the building of roads begins. So yung importance ng ating mga engineers lalo na sir dito sa yung Pamana sir na ano.
Mm-hmm.
So
Pamana projects.
Pamana projects ng ating government.
What's that saying sa IPSP? Winning, what's that?
Winning the peace.
Winning the peace.
Dinagdagan lang natin ito na hindi lang winning the peace, pati peace and progress.
Mm-mm.
Progress and prosperity.
Winning the hearts and minds.
Yes. So, pero pag na-win na namin yung heart nyo at saka yung heart ng lahat ng nandito sa Visayas, kailangan makikita na mayroong development.
Mm-mm.
Ito yung ni-spouse ng ating chief of staff na kailangan kaakibat yung economic indicators na mayroong sumibol na magandang pamumuhay ng taong bayan ng Visayas.
Because I believe if there's economic progress, there's no reason for insurgency.
Yes, definitely. Yes, definitely.
Mm-hmm. And vice versa, if we have peace, then progress will follow.
Mm-hmm.
And if we have this progressive life, then there is no insurgency.
Mm-hmm. Currently, sir, what are our partnership programs, if any, with the provincial or city government of Cebu? Are there any?
Partnerships, security tayo palagi.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, sir. And the number one, sir, is HADR.
HADR, of course, mm-hmm. security.
Mm-hmm.
But every day, yung daily activities namin is security.
Mm-hmm.
Madami kasing mangyayari dito, participant security. Of course, yung HADR kasi, hindi natin alam kung kailan dadating eh.
Mm-hmm.
But security aspect, like for example, ito, dadating ang Pope. Mm-hmm. Area ng CENTCOM yan. Dakating ang APEC meeting. So, may role ang Central Command yan.
And also, right now, sir, we have the United States CBs building schools sa within Cebu Province. So, it is ongoing na.
Mm-hmm.
So far, they have built 10 schools in Carcar, Aloginsan, Toledo. And then this coming 20 November, magkakaroon kami ng media caravan and we will be inviting the media. Iikuti namin yung mga areas na yon. So yun ang magiging activities. And also one of the pre-anniversary activities ng CENTCOM is meron na na-cover na po natin lahat ng areas and also yung environment na aspect na responsibility ng CENTCOM.
Mm-hmm.
So this coming Wednesday, we will be also planting 100 trees. Hindi lang planting pala, tree planting and growing. So kailangan pag na-plant, susubaybayan natin na lumaki siya.
Hopefully it will be sustained because usually
plant pag-plant, pinababayaan.
Kaya may kasama ng grow.
Tree planting and growing. Talagang
tree planting and growing.
This coming Wednesday on November 19.
I think Attorney Gloria Ramos, she's an environmental lawyer. She'll be very happy to hear that. Mm. She's also a part of our organization, the Cebu Lady Lawyers Association.
Mm. Actually, merong press briefing in the morning. Uh-oh. And we will have a presentation from the DENR. So maraming lectures sir ng about climate change. Mm. And everything in the, about the environment. And then in the afternoon, yun na yung tree planting within Central Command.
Mm-mm. Sir, I believe prior to you being commander of SANCOM, you were commander 3rd Air Division.
Yes, that is in Zamboanga.
In
yes,
Zamboanga, yes. Sir. In Andrews.
Edwin Andrews Air Base.
Edwin Andrews. And prior to that, sir, can you share to the viewers how you were able to join the armed forces? A little background, sir.
A little background, huh? Well, I entered the academy in 1978, mm-hmm. and I graduated in 1982. Mm-hmm. And I joined the Air Force. Mm-hmm. Then, of course, I joined the flying school so that I'm maging piloto, mm-hmm. ika nga. And for so many years, I've been flying, and then madami na ako napuntahan. Itong huli ko nga is the 3rd Air Division Commander ng Air Force prior to my assignment to Central Command. Mm-hmm. Naging assistant superintendent din ako ng PMA, mm-hmm. where we came from, of course.
This is prior to your post
sa 3rd Air Division, yes. And mahaba, masyadong 30 plus years na ako that more than 3 decades kasi pagka ikinuwento ko yung pagpasok ko sa servisyo masyado nang mahaba yan. And aabutin tayo ng matagal-tagal. But definitely one of the most challenging job that I have is right now is as the commander of the Central Command. And kahit naman medyo mahirap pero maganda naman dito sa Cebu kasi nakikita ko na magkakaroon ng magandang development dito sa region na ito, sa Visayas region. So, hopefully, we can hit our targets and I can see no reason why we will not celebrate for Christmas because of this achievement of the Central Command. So, Merry Christmas. I don't answer.
Our viewers may not believe this, but I think your staff shared to me earlier na you're a great singer daw. I would have wanted you to sing, but I don't think you will indulge our viewers.
Ano lang yun, chismis lang siguro.
Chismis lang.
But when I retire, after my retirement in August of 2016, baka subukan ko magkaroon ng ibang karir.
Sa entertainment.
Sa entertainment. I'm just kidding.
Ikaw, sir, can you please tell us, you're also from the academy.
Hindi po. I came from Iloilo and I finished my Bachelor of Science in Commerce, major in Accounting, last 1985. Mm-hmm. At nakapasok po ako sa Philippine Air Force Flying School, mm-hmm. Sa Aviation Cadet. At nakagraduate po ako noong 1988. After that, na-assign na po ako sa 15th Strike Wing, flying the Tora Tora. Mm-hmm. Then later, naging OV-10 ng ma-face out na yung Tora Tora. And prior to my assignment also in CENCOM, mm-hmm. I was able to serve also General Bibar at 3rd Air Division in Zamboanga City. Doon po nangyari nga yung sikat na Zamboanga crisis and we were there. And
yes, you were there during the siege.
Yes, my commander was General Bibar. Mm-hmm. And that will be part of history, mm-hmm. that kumbaga the armed forces was successful in defending that particular place against the intruders, which are the rogue MNLF. Mm-hmm.
So, speaking of the Zamboanga siege, how does it differ, sir, from addressing disasters and calamities? Parang pareho lang ba, sir, yung
conflict? Hindi. Sabihin natin medyo delikado ang Zamboanga siege, ano, kasi malakas yung kalaban, but mas mahirap yung calamities. Like for example, the Yolanda. halos i-flatten niya yung buong region.
Mm-hmm.
Sa Zamboanga Seeds, may baril sila, may baril kami.
Mm-hmm.
So, patas na lamang, in fact, lamang kami. Kasi we have the Air Force, we have the Navy, we have the Army, and so on and so forth. So, kaya para sa akin, mas mabigat itong SADR. Ang paglaban kasi sa insurgency at paglaban sa mga rogue elements ng kalaban ng state ay napapag-aralan. Itong SADR, napapag-aralan nga, napapaghandaan, subalit hindi natin alam kung gaano kalakas. If I remember right, the Yolanda, ang pagkaparehan nito during sa bombing ng Nagasaki o sa ano to? Sa Japan?
Hiroshima
bombing ng nuclear. Sabi nila it's 10 times than the
Hiroshima bombing.
Hiroshima bombing yung nuclear. So, can you imagine that?
Mm-hmm.
At saka makita mo na lang sa mga sa casualty. Ang casualty natin sa gera, hindi naman ganun kadami. Siguro 10, 20. Sa mga kalaban, isama mo na, palagay natin yung mga by hundreds.
Mm.
Ang calamity, Yolanda, latest na nakita ko sa diary was more than 6,000 and yung missing, ang dami. So, can you imagine kung gaano kabigat ang calamity? So, mas mabigat ang calamity. That is my personal perception.
And how was that, sir? Fighting Filipinos during Zamboanga Siege?
Hindi masyado maganda kasi they are our
brothers.
It breaks
your heart. Yes.
Yeah. Hindi masaya. It's not. Sana huwag na ulit.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya nga, hinihimo ko na yung nasa kaliwa, yung nating mga kapatid na nasa New People's Army na tayo na lang magsama-sama for the development of Visayas.
Mm-hmm.
At tigilan na natin tong arm struggle. Mag-usap na tayo sa table.
And I believe there are success stories na our brothers and sisters who have return to government.
Yes, sa ngayon ang dami na naming na pumupunta na sa amin and joining the government.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya I'm positive na we can handle the target of course maging peaceful na itong buong Visayas. So, ganun pa din, ulit ko, medyo mas mabigat ang SADR calamity. Napakadami kasing namamatay. Kaya kailangan talagang paghandaan. Kaya lagi na lamang kaming na gumagawa ng paraan upang ma-improve yung aming plan for the SADR tsaka gamit.
Because disaster preparedness, it's not a question if it happens, it's only a question when.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Mm-hmm. And I believe we only have a few minutes left, so I'd like to ask our guests for a few parting words, sir.
Well, kami nagpapasalamat sa Marge, Attorney Marge, for this interview. Oh. Na at least na ipakita namin sa mamamayan ng ating Visayas region na mayroon kaming anniversary at siguro nabigyan namin ng liwanag yung mga nangyayari dito sa Kabisayaan, pati na rin doon sa ibang lugar na ating pinag-usapan. So, kayo po yung aming inaanyayahan at makisama sa aming anniversary sa December 1. And yun lamang po. At siguro, maayong gabi sa inyong tanan, tama ba?
Colonel Gutico, sir.
Yes, we are very happy that we have this chance to tell our countrymen all about CENTCOM at ano yung ginagawa ng CENTCOM sa paggawa ng mga proyekto ng gobyerno sa pagtulong sa pag-maintain ng peace and order sa ating area and even the preparation for any calamities that may strike the Visayas area. So, ito po ang CENTCOM. Ang sinasabi namin, we are your the peacemakers of the Visayas and we are always ready to provide service to our countrymen with, of course, the able leadership of our commander and with the cooperation and support of all our personnel sa Central Command. So again, thank you po at mayong gabi sa inyong tanan.
And also, as mentioned earlier, so kung may mga queries po tayo, anything CENTCOM, yung public information office po natin, ang hotline po niyan is 0917-302-3335.
I'd like to thank our guests for this evening, Lieutenant General Nicanor Vivar, Commander of Central Command, Colonel Samuel Gutico, Staff for Operations U3 Central Command, Lieutenant Commander Jim Aris Alagao, Chief Public Information Office. Magpasalamat yung kuanin nila, ni anhini sila, despite their busy schedules. Gihatagan yung tanlag higayon nga magka-estudya nila. Karon hibawaan na to, unsay role sa atong armed forces din he. Pabesa lang giingon, ang atong armed forces, sila ni atong peacemaker sa Visayas. Manghinaot ko katong wa ni ko yung sa gobyerno mo balik sa ato ah. Dayon karong gabiyon na magpasalamat sa ko sa atong mga tanang viewers nga naminaw. In behalf sa Cebu Lady Lawyers Association, kini si Attorney Margarita yung nagpasalamat sa inyong tanan. Maayong gabi eh.